Hey everyone, Sanjay from Contriver podcast, and you're listening to Constant Show episode number 81. And today we're going to talk about what is a public limited. Why is it really called as public limited or a limited company? Let's get started. So public limited, what does that mean? I'm not going to give you the private limited definition again. Public limited in the sense, anyone who is public of that particular country, they can really buy the stock of a company. Who are public? Public in the sense, the citizens of that particular company, they can really buy, share of that particular company. I'm not going to get into this, DMAT account, NSE, BSE, day trading, dividend, shareholders, all that in this particular video. I have an other series, I have an other episodes coming up for that particular things. So as of now, let's discuss about public limited. So once you start a company, it could be private limited or it could be something else. You start a company, after a certain period, you should file your company. You can file your company. It's not a compulsion that you have to do it. You can file a company as IPO, that is initial public offering. I'll let you know what is that. Initial public offering in the sense, anyone else in the entire country who is really eligible. Eligibility criteria in the sense, they should have a DMAT account. So once they have the particular account, they can really invest in your particular company. Let's say that you just announce 1000 shares as public in your own company. So what happens, there is a chance that 1000 different people in and around your country can purchase that particular share. I know this is getting a little bit tricky, but I'll let you know what are share or all that in our further videos. As of now, public limited in the sense, anyone else in this entire country can purchase your share, and it's 100% or 200% sure that no company can make as a public limited as soon as the first day that they launch. They need lots of experience, and they have lots of rules to become a public limited company. And it is also important that maximum shareholders, let's say you just release 1000 shares in your company, and 1000 shares is somewhere around 100% of your entire company shares. Let's just assume your company is a big apple pie now, not apple company, an apple pie that you can eat. And you just divided your company, your apple pie into 100 different pieces. What you are supposed to do now is, you give one particular pie to someone else and he gives you certain money. So after baking that pie, I'm telling you that after baking that pie, you give some one particular piece to one particular person, and let's name that particular apple pie as your lovable company, the company called as Love. Okay, what do you do if one person just purchased 60 different pieces of apple pie? What happens? That particular person is the highest shareholder of your company called as Love, the apple pie company. Okay, so that person has more rights than the person who owns 40% or 40 different pieces of apple pie. Let's say I am the inventor, I am the cook, I am the chef of that particular apple pie company, but still I just hold 40% of that apple pie, whereas 60% of that apple pie is being given to someone else. They have bought that. That means they have more rights on the company that I have created. This is how most of the company get broke and most of the business owners get broke. And what happens next? That 60% person who have just acquired your company, they can change the board of directors, they can elect a different CEO, they can do anything, literally anything in the company that you really created. they can eat the company, they can store that, they can eat the apple pie, or they can really store that particular apple pie, package that, sell it to someone else for greater money. All that things can happen. So that is how public limiteds are. And this trick, as I said, you bake an apple pie, but someone else's own the 60% of an apple pie, and you have no rights anymore to own that particular apple pie, saying that this apple pie was baked by me and that belongs to me. You can't do that. And this is the same story happened between Jaguar and Tata. Tata acquired Jaguar. How did they do that? In the sense, they purchased the most number of the share from Jaguar. And once you just make your company as a public company, how many shares, what's the net worth of your company? How much share out of that particular thing do you give it for public? That really matters. And for the minimum number of people, for a public company is 7, CR7, Cristiano Ronaldo number, right? And Dhoni fans, you guys can feel so happy. Minimum number of people for public limited is 7, and minimum number of money that you need, the capital that you need for that particular company to be started is 5 lakhs rupees again. And maximum number of people can be unlimited for a public limited. Maximum number of shareholders can be unlimited. And yeah, this is about public limited, guys. And in our next video, we'll discuss another thing. And so huge shout out for my man Vinay Putankar. When you look for money, you get rich. When you look for legacy, you build wealth. And that is the thing that Vinay really commented on. And thanks a lot, Vinay, for commenting on our post. And it means the world to me. And he's a multi-talented person. People tell me that I have lots of talent, I have lots of niche, I have lots of things to do. I am interested in everything. What do I do? But Vinay is a great example for that. He's an artist, he's a good, choreographer, he's a good dancer. He's also one of the, good chef, he's a model, he's participating for Mr. India, all that. But right now he's into his own quest, saying that he's multi-talented guy, he's into saying that he want to be a chef. That is what he is passionate about. So this is what I do. I share about people who are really interested into our community. I'll share about different people. I have many people who are really interested in doing what they really love about, and people who chase their passion. That is about our community, right? So I thank a lot people who really take some 15 seconds extra to comment on my post, to comment on my videos. So drop your thoughts on the comment section. So we are a knowledgeable community. As of now, we are somewhere around 100. Yeah, 100 as of now. We are still growing, we are still small, but still, I hope we as a community are really a good people. And comment down. I'll meet you in our next video, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.